Okay, it's getting kind of chilly today. Tons of mist actually because of the weather. It looks really cool at times anyways when you look at the time lapse. And with that in mind, what's going on today? It was the huge announcements in CES 2025 for a lot of companies. I was trying to read about what's new, I guess, in the drone world. It's kind of interesting seeing, I guess, a different type of drones that got recognition of sort. So having a quick look at some of these drones, how about this one? This one says the Verde Pit Mini, a smart landing pad for pre-flight inspection and storage of small drones used for filming, surveillance, and reconnaissance, ensuring easy use. Man, that sounds like a pretty broad range of usage for that. Would a regular person use this as well as, let's just say, some kind of official? It says the Verde Pit Mini by Weflow is a compact intelligent drone inspection solution that utilizes non-contact sensors and AI-driven diagnostics to eliminate the need for manual inspections. Leveraging advanced AI algorithms and an extensive database, the system offers precise fault diagnosis and predictive maintenance, ensuring enhanced performance and safety for drones. This innovative approach streamlines the inspection process, making it more efficient and effective. I guess what that says is meant more for people doing work. Although I wouldn't doubt in the future a regular person would be able to use something like this, like a docking station of sort anyways, if they don't want to be bothered in terms of, let's just say, inspecting their own home actually. If you just want to see what's going on in the roof and all that. And then this other one looks kind of interesting. You know what the typical quadcopter drone looks like, but how about this one? Urban Bladeless Delivery Drone System. When I first looked at this, I just thought it was like a toy or something. Doesn't that kind of look weird for, I guess, a delivery drone per se? It says the bladeless drone is an innovative unmanned aerial vehicle that enhances safety and quietness through its bladeless propulsion technology. Its design eliminates propellers, reducing noise by over 40%, making it ideal for urban environments. Capable of carrying up to 10 kilograms of cargo, it utilizes an AI-based smart flight system and smart air cargo system to safely and accurately deliver sensitive items like food and medicine in complex urban settings. Equipped with real-time monitoring, it tracks delivery routes and status. So that's kind of cool. Actually, this would be really useful for, I guess, recreational drones if you're just capturing videos and stuff like that. The fact that it reduces things like noise and stuff like that, which is often a complaint when people are doing filming. And here it talks about an underground drone, and it was interesting because it says Skyflight Hansio University. It says our underground drone can perform autonomous flights by utilizing LiDAR in environments where GPS signals are unavailable, creating real-time 3D maps of surroundings and estimating their position. In irregular underground environments, the drone uses 360 degrees LiDAR to comprehensively capture the entire surroundings, detecting obstacles and preventing collisions. That's more common nowadays too when you hear about it in terms of companies developing drones. They don't want to be reliant just on things like GPS. And this was kind of expected where there's more drones for people like first responders, because it says here, station for drone first responder. The station for DFR isn't just an add-on, it's pivotal for achieving true autonomy in drone systems. Serving as an advanced drone base, it seamlessly integrates with police operating systems and autonomously obtains flight authorization, enabling drones to act as reliable, immediate responders in critical situations, extending beyond routine patrols to urgent incident response. That makes me wonder how that would work, actually, saying autonomously obtains flight authorization. Because in a lot of cases anyways, if you want to fly in certain areas, just as, let's just say, a regular person or maybe like a small business, you usually have to jump through hoops. So in this case, will they basically just get the green light to do whatever they please immediately? It just keeps a record of your flight, and then afterwards you're just like, okay, whatever, you are, for example, an emergency worker, so we'll let you do whatever you feel is appropriate during that time. Like, what happens if there's all that stuff like last year with those mystery drones and there's a flight ban, for example? Would they be exempt from this? And the last one I saw, which is kind of a design I've seen before, where you've seen these drones go around caves. This one here is, it's the Hagamosphere. The Hagamosphere is a spheric drone with 8 propellers mounted on a cubic frame, allowing it to move both horizontally and vertically while maintaining balance. It is also designed to rotate on the ground by housing itself inside a geometrically shaped sphere guard. This new type of multi-copter drone created by DIC is expected to play an active role in a wide variety of scenarios. So a lot of, I guess you could say, innovations in terms of the design look and so forth. And there was a bunch of other companies announcing their products. I think one of the bigger ones that people were interested in hearing was NVIDIA and their new graphics cards. With all the buzz and so forth about people wanting to get into AI and so forth, graphics cards have just been ridiculous in terms of prices. So I wouldn't be surprised if these, regardless of the price, it sells out, correct? I actually have to still upgrade my computer. Actually, I'm using a really old one still. I think it's of all time too. With these types of announcements, I'm usually thinking, okay, is it good to get something, for example, that's newer like this, or should you get something older because the prices should theoretically drop for the older line?
All right, see you guys later.